All right, so we are here with Leonardo da Vinci's ghost. That's right, we are interviewing ghosts for this one. I'm going to start off with the first question. When and where were you born?
I was born April 15th, 1452, in the place of Vinci, Italy.
Oh, that makes me feel young. Thank you very much. What were your parents like? What was life like?
My parents actually never married. My mom was a peasant, and my father was a nobility.
Pretty wide range of personalities. Through that family life, how did you develop the artistic skills?
Well, they just came naturally to me, you know. But I never actually received an education at all.
Self-taught?
Yeah.
Nice! Okay, because of your artistic skills, you became the Renaissance man. Tell me a little bit about it.
Well, I love that because I was very talented in many things, such as math and science and art.
Okay, as a Renaissance man, what is some of the few things people don't know about you?
Well, one time I was commissioned to create a giant warhorse, but I never actually finished it.
Oh, yeah, you have any other inventions?
I have many ideas, but I never actually fulfilled them.
Okay, what are your most famous technical inventions? What's the Mona Lisa? How long did it take and what was the process like?
It took quite a long time.
Do you get arrested in your time for any goofy shenanigans about your art or something like that?
Sorry.
Oh, okay, never mind. So after a lifelong success journey, when did you die?
I died on May 24th, 1519.
Okay, thank you very much. That was such a fun interview. Alright, so our second interview of the day is Harry Truman. We're going to start off with the first question, where and when were you born?
I was born on May 8th, 1884 in Lamont, Missouri.
Alright, so what was your young life like, just developing into the adult you were?
Well, when I was 6 years old, I moved to a lot of places, like to Independence, Missouri.
Ooh, well, that is some places. So I heard you tried to get into West Point, but didn't really work out. What happened?
I didn't get to West Point because of my poor vision.
Alrighty, well, besides the disappointment with West Point, I heard you were in the artillery regiment. What exactly is that?
The 129th Artillery is a weapons branch in the U.S. Army.
Okay, cool. So, when did you get in there?
I became a member on June 14th, 1905.
Okay. So, as you got through the regiment and couple other things, you became Senate.
Yep.
Where and when did that happen?
I was elected to Senate on November 6, 1934, and I represented the state of Missouri.
Alright, as you went through the Senate and maybe a couple other things, parts of the government, how did you become president?
I became president when Franklin D. Roosevelt died in 1945 in the waning days of World War II.
Now, I'm probably going to ask, like, probably the million-dollar question here, but what was the reason you dropped the atomic bombs on Japan?
I did because I wanted to protect their soldiers who were fighting the war.
Okay. I definitely understand that. Who succeeded you after your term was done?
That was in 1953 when Dwight D. Eisenhower ascended to presidency.
Okay, and as all our last questions, have a lot of last questions. Where and when did you die?
I died in December 26, 1972 in Kansas City.
Alright, now it's time for our third interviewee, Gabrielo Prince. So as we start off with every interview, we're going to start where and when were you born?
I was born on July 25th, 1894 in Oblojan, Bosnia.
Okay, that's a great place, I'll tell you. Alright, family life. How was it?
I lived pretty well. I was the son of a postman and one of 9 children.
That's got to be a handful for parents. So you joined this famous organization, and it's called the Black Hand. What exactly is that? When did you get in?
The Black Hand is pretty much just like a secret society that I joined to sit behind the ropes.
Okay. What do you think you were famous for? Because there are many